You're working in Visual Studio Code. You open up a very deeply nested project. You head over to the terminal and you find that your path in your command prompt is extremely large, and that kind of gets in the way. The first command you can utilize to kind of clear the screen, if it gets a little bit full, is CLS. So CLS, press enter, that would clear the screen. But you're still left with this very long path. So to get rid of that, let's type in PROMP, prompt, and then you'll need the dollar sign and G. Simply now just press enter, and there we go. We now have a very clean command prompt. So at this point, you spend a bit of time trying to type in prompt $G, and it doesn't work. Well, that's because here you'll notice that we've opened up a PowerShell instance. This will only work if you're using a command prompt. Again, this is all Windows-based. So again, if I type in prompt here and then $G, that would then change. You can see here the prompt path, and we just have the right chevron. So it's important to remember that PowerShell works slightly different. So in PowerShell, let's type in dollar. I don't know why it's doing that. Let's press enter and I'll clear that. So let's type in dollar and then profile. Here you can see that the profile for this is stored at this location right here. So let's just take this location. So I've gone ahead and copied the link into File Explorer. And you can see here that Windows cannot find the file. The likelihood is that we haven't created a file. So let's go ahead and do that. So first of all, let's just paste that back in. This is the file name, Microsoft.PowerShell_profile_ps1. So I'll just get rid of that, go over to the folder, and then create a new file. So you can see what's happened here is that we've created this file here. We've utilized the name .ps1, but you can see it's a text document still, and that's not what we want. So let's just open this up. Let's go into file save as, and let's save this as the name that we pasted, but this time all files, press save. So you can see that this time, I'll close this, this time you can see that we've created now a new file, a new Windows PowerShell script. So let's get rid of the text document. So let's go ahead and edit this file. Right click, open with. Let's just use Notepad. Okay. And then within Notepad, let's now configure our command prompt. As you might imagine, there's a few different options here, but I've typed in function prompt. I've then changed and removed the path, and we're left with just the chevron in the actual command prompt now. So with this configuration, that will remove the path, and that should now leave us with a shorter command line. So let's take a look. So this is our current command line. You can see it has the path and so on. It's very messy. So let's go ahead and just add a new PowerShell. And you can see straight away, we're just left really with the chevron here. And we are still in the current directory. You can see by typing in dir, but this time we avoid and we have removed the path.